Welcome to Next Gen Study, and in today's video we'll discuss on the topic of deformation under law of torts. Have a look at what is deformation. In layman's words, one can say that deformation is the action of damaging the reputation of a person or group by saying or writing bad things about them that are not true. Or we can also say that any false intentional communication, either written or spoken, that harms a person's reputation, decreases the respect, regard, or confidence in which a person is held, or induces disparaging, hostile, or disagreeable opinions or feelings against a person is known as defamation. So, koi bhi aisa act ya koi bhi aisa statement, now statement can be either written or spoken, that harms a person's reputation, decreases respect, regard, or confidence in which a person is held, and induces disparaging, hostile, or disagreeable opinions which make society against him, basically is known as defamation. Different jurists, according to their perspective, have given various definitions of defamation. So we'll have a look at three of them. So first, according to Winfield, defamation is the publication of a statement which tends to lower a person in the estimation of right-thinking members of the society generally, or which tends to make them shun or avoid that person. So Winfield ये बोलना चाहता है कि defamation कोई भी ऐसा publication होता है एक statement का जिससे एक इंसान की reputation गिर जाती है society में and जिससे society prefer करती है कि वो उस इंसान को avoid करें. Now Salmon says defamation consists in the publication of false and defamatory statement concerning another without lawful justification. तो सैल्मन बोलता है कि डिफॉर्मेशन कोई भी ऐसा पब्लिकेशन होता है किसी फॉल्स या डिफॉर्मेटरी स्टेटमेंट का जिसके लिए कोई भी लॉफुल जस्टिफिकेशन नहीं हो सकता. अब किसी की रेपुटेशन ऐसे ही डैमेज नहीं कर सकते विदाउट एनी लॉफुल जस्टिफिकेशन. सो दैट इज़ व्हाट सैल्मन सेज. अकॉर्डिंग टू अंडरहिल, डिफॉर्मेशन इज द पब्लिकेशन ऑफ अ फॉल्स एंड डिफॉर्मेटरी स्टेटमेंट कंसर्निंग अनदर विदाउट अ जस्ट कॉज और एक्सक्यूज व्हेरबाय ही सफर्स इंजरी टू हिज रेपुटेशन. यू सी ऑल द थ्री स्टेटमेंट्स आर सिमिलर. वेयर द पब्लिकेशन इज फॉल्स एंड डिफॉर्मेटरी, देर इज नो जस्टिफिकेशन एंड देर इज इंजरी टू हिज रेपुटेशन. सो दैट इज बेसिकली वॉट डिफॉर्मेशन इज. डिफॉर्मेशन मे बी अ सिविल चार्ज. अभी सिविल चार्ज इसलिए होगा क्योंकि हर इंसान के पास राइट होता है टू लिव हिज लाइफ इन डिग्निटी विद डिग्निटी. एंड अगर आप किसी को डिफेम करते हो तो आप उसके राइट टू रेपुटेशन को, मतलब राइट ऑफ रेपुटेशन को हैम्पर करते हो. सो इसलिए इट माइट बी अ सिविल चार्ज और इट कैन ऑल्सो बी अ क्रिमिनल चार्ज अंडर सेक्शन 499 और 500 ऑफ IPC. सो सेक्शन 499 डील्स विद द definition gives the definition of defamation and section 500 on the other hand gives the punishments. Now, section 499 of IPC says whoever by words either spoken or intended to be read or by signs or by visible representations makes or publishes any imputation concerning any person intending to harm or knowing or having reason to believe that such imputation will harm the reputation of such person is said to defame that person. सो सेक्शन 499 सेज कोई भी ऐसा विजुअल या स्पोकन या रिटन रिप्रेजेंटेशन जिससे किसी इंसान की रेपुटेशन को हार्म पहुंचता है एंड उस इंसान जो भी ऐसा पब्लिकेशन बना रहा है उसको पता हो कि उससे उस इंसान के रेपुटेशन को हार्म पहुंचेगा तो उसने वो इंटेंशनली किया. इट मीन्स तो सच पर्सन इज सेड टू डिफेम अ पर्सन. ना Section 500 of IPC gives punishments for defamation. Now, whoever defames another shall be punished with simple imprisonment for a term which may extend up to 2 years, or with fine or both. Talk about types of defamation. Defamation is of two kinds, libel and slander. Libel is permanent or mostly in written form, and slander, on the other hand, is transitory, which means not permanent, and which is basically verbal or oral. Now let's define them. Libel is publication of a false and defamatory statement in some permanent form, tending to injure the reputation of another person without lawful justification or excuse. इसके एग्जाम्पल होंगे राइटिंग, प्रिंटिंग, पिक्चर, एफिगे. नाउ एफिगे मीन्स अ स्कल्पचर, ऑनलाइन पब्लिकेशन, कार्टून्स एक्सेट्रा. नाउ अगर ये इन सब एग्जाम्पल्स को देखा जाए तो दे आर इन परमानेंट फॉर्म. अगर एक बार पब्लिश हो गया इट कैन नॉट बी रिमूव फ्रॉम ईच एंड एवरी प्लेस. सो दैट इज़ वाई लेबल इज इन परमानेंट फॉर्म. स्लैंडर. स्लैंडर इज फॉल्स और डिफॉर्मेटरी स्टेटमेंट विच माइट बी वर्बल और ओरल इन सम ट्रांजिटरी फॉर्म टेंडिंग टू इंजर द रेपुटेशन ऑफ अनदर विदाउट लॉफुल जस्टिफिकेशन और एक्सक्यूज. अब इसके एग्जाम्पल्स हो जाएंगे वर्ड्स अटर्ड, कमेंट्स, एक्सप्लेनेशन और कुछ भी ऐसी चीज़ जो टेलीविजन या रेडियो पर बोला गया हो. दिस नो स्लैंडर कैन बी कॉल्ड एज रूमर्स विच आर स्प्रेड. सो रूमर्स एज वी ऑल नो आर नॉट परमानेंट. सो दे आर अ ग्रेट एग्जाम्पल फॉर स्लैंडर. टेबल बिलो क्लियरली शोज डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन लेबल एंड स्लैंडर. नाउ फर्स्ट लेट्स हैव अ लुक एट लेबल. लेबल इज इन रिटन और परमानेंट फॉर्म and it is actionable per se in all cases. The actual publisher will not be liable on libel and it is both civil and criminal wrong. While slander is in transitory, which is a non-permanent form, it is not actionable per se in all cases. If in slander, the plaintiff has to prove that he has been defamed, only then the suit will be actionable. In slander, in every case, the publisher is liable and it is only a civil wrong. Look at what are the essentials for defamation. So, for a successful claim under defamation, the plaintiff must prove that the statement which was said or published by the defendant was false and defamatory, and there must be an actual publication of the statement, and there must be injury to his reputation. So the first essential, false or defamatory statement, it means that if the statement is not false or actual narration, it does not amount to defamation. Now here statement includes both written and oral statement. अगर कोई इंसान कोई भी फैक्ट पब्लिश कर रहा है या फिर कोई भी फैक्ट बता रहा है लोगों के सामने, now that will not amount to defamation. There's a word innuendo. The word innuendo refers to indirect hint. Sometimes a statement may prima facie look innocent, but it may have some latent meaning. कोई ऐसा छुपा हुआ मतलब होता है इसमें, which may be considered defamatory. In such cases, the plaintiff has the burden to prove that the statement had a latent meaning and has to show the evidence of defamation. Here, which the plaintiff has to prove is that there was publication of such statement, such false statement. It means that the contents of defamatory statements are conveyed to someone else other than the plaintiff. Now, if the defendant has communicated a defamatory statement only to the plaintiff and no one else, it shall not amount to defamation. If the defamatory letter is sent to plaintiff, let's imagine A sends a defamatory letter to B, it is most likely to be read by his friends or family members or anyone else. So in such case, there is a publication. And the third most important element we might call is injury. Now the above published statement must have caused injury to the subject of the statement. It means that the statement must tend to injure the reputation of a person to whom it refers. Have a look at cases in defamation. D.P. Chaudhary versus Kumari Manjulata. AIR 1997 ka case hai ye. To iske facts kuch aise the. Respondent, that is Kumari Manjulata, she was 17 years of age and belonged to a well-off family and she studied B.A. तो एक दिन द लोकल डेली दैट इज दैनिक नवज्योति न्यूज़पेपर में एक पब्लिकेशन आया दैट लास्ट नाइट शी रैन अवे विद अ बॉय नेम्ड कमलेश ट्रूथ बीइंग दैट शी हैड ओनली गॉन टू अटेंड नाइट क्लासेस. द न्यूज़ आइटम वाज अनट्रू एंड नेग्लिजेंटली पब्लिश्ड विद अटर इररिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. शी वाज शॉक्ड एंड रिडिक्यूल्ड बाय अदर्स. इट वाज हेल्ड that the action was defamatory and she was entitled for damages of ₹10,000 by the way of general damages. So you see this is case mein matlab sare essentials defamation ke fulfill hote hai. There was a false statement which was published and due to which रिस्पोंडेंट दैट इज मंजुलता वॉज रिडिक्यूल्ड बाई अदर्स, तो उसकी रेप्यूटेशन को इंजरी पहुंची. सो दैट इज वाई द एक्ट इज कंसिडर्ड एज डिफेमेटेड इज मॉरिसन वर्सेस रिची एंड कॉर्पोरेशन. 1902 का केस है ये. The facts of the case were as such. Ritchie was the publisher of a Scotsman newspaper. The Scotsman in 1901 printed that a couple, Morrison, was married. And a month later, a second notice was posted saying that their twin children were born. The reason it was considered defamatory was because of the innuendo that it had a latent meaning that which was raised from the background knowledge which people may have. The people would be able to tell that they had been engaging in certain activities that were frowned upon before they were married. Now, in the suit filed, it was held that the statement was defamatory. The damages were recovered against the proprietors of the paper, who in all innocence had announced that in their paper that a lady who had in fact been married only for a month had given birth to twins. This is a defamation. Justification or truth? The truth is an absolute defense to defamation. Now that is because if you recall when we read the essentials for defamation, the first essential was that the statement must be false. So if the statement was accurate or a fact, then by definition it wasn't defamatory. The second is fair comment. Now, that if the defendant wants to take a defense under this, he has the burden to prove the following points. The first, that the statement must be an expression of opinion rather than assertion of fact. The second is that the comment must be fair, which means without malice or any wrongful, unlawful intention. The third is that the matter commented upon must be of public interest, which one can take in defamation as privilege. Now, there are certain occasions when law recognizes right to freedom above the plaintiff's right to reputation, and those occasions are treated as privileged ones. Now, privileged occasions are further of two types, absolute and qualified. So, absolute privilege means that no action lies for the defamatory statement, even though the statement is false or made maliciously. Now, example, statements made in court or parliamentary privilege or state communication. Now, the second one is qualified privilege. It means that the person making the alleged defamatory statement must have had some right to make that statement. If a qualified privilege applies to a statement, it means that the person suing for defamation must prove that the person who made the defamatory statement acted intentionally, recklessly, or with malice, hatred, spite, ill will, or resentment, depending on each state's law. So, iska example ho sakta hai when film critiques, when a critic gives his review on films, he say some mean statements. Now, for that to be defamatory, the director, producer, or the actor against whomever the statement is made must prove that the statement was made intentionally and recklessly, or with some bad intention or hatred against him. That's it for this video. Now, if you like the video, do like, share, and subscribe to our channel Next Gen Study and click the bell icon to get all the notifications from our channel. Thank you.